The Jewish people recognized that they had a special relationship with God, arising from the covenant that was established at Mount Sinai. But now they are hearing rumors that Gentiles are being received in the Church of Jesus Christ without them first coming under the covenant of Israel, without them becoming Jews. Indeed, that Peter has initiated this move, and this causes great consternation. The apostles and brethren who were in Judea heard that the Gentiles had also received the word of God. And when Peter came up to Jerusalem, those of the circumcision contended with him, saying, "You went to uncircumcised men and ate with them." But Peter explained it to them in order from the beginning, saying, "I was in the city of Joppa praying, and in a trance I saw a vision, an object ascending like a great sheet, let down from heaven by four corners, and it came to me. When I observed it intently and considered, I saw four-footed animals of the earth, wild beasts, creeping things, and birds of the air. And I heard a voice saying to me, 'Arise, Peter, kill and eat.' But I said, 'Not so, Lord, for nothing common or unclean has at any time entered my mouth.' But the voice answered me again from heaven, 'What God has cleansed, you must not call common.' Now this was done three times, and all were drawn up again into heaven. At that very moment, three men stood before the house where I was, having been sent to me from Caesarea. Then the Spirit told me to go with them, doubting nothing. Moreover, these six brethren accompanied me, and we entered the man's house. And he told us how he had seen an angel standing in his house, who said to him, 'Send men to Joppa and call for Simon, whose surname is Peter, who will tell you words by which you and your household will be saved.' And as I began to speak, the Holy Spirit fell upon them, as upon us at the beginning. And I remembered the word of the Lord, how he said, 'John indeed baptized with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit.' If therefore God gave them the same gift as he gave us when we believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, who was I that I could withstand God?" When they heard these things, they became silent, and they glorified God, saying, "Then God has also granted to the Gentiles repentance to life." My name's Arthur, and I thank you for joining me as we share together from Acts chapter 11, verses 1 to 18, the conclusion of this matter of the gospel coming to the Gentiles. The separation of Jew from Gentile, particularly of an Orthodox Jew from Gentile, had been ingrained in the people for hundreds of years, and it was a fence that was necessary and has continued to be necessary with respect to the Jews throughout the centuries, to maintain their identity, that they not become like the Gentiles, for they are to be a distinct people. But when it comes to the message of Jesus Christ and the sovereignty of Jesus Christ, the Old Testament scriptures make it plain that he is not just king of Israel, but he is king of the whole world. For example, Isaiah 49 is a passage concerning the servant of the Lord. And verse 5 says, "And now the Lord says, who formed me from the womb to be his servant, to bring Jacob back to him, so that Israel is gathered to him. For I shall be glorious in the eyes of the Lord, and my God shall be my strength. Indeed," he says, "it is too small a thing that you should be my servant to raise up the tribes of Jacob and to restore the preserved ones of Israel. I will also give you as a light to the Gentiles, that you shall be my salvation to the ends of the earth." These verses plainly speak of a servant formed in the womb, that is, a natural man, who will not only restore Israel to the worship of God, but is also given leadership of the Gentiles. "I will also give you as a light to the Gentiles, that you shall be my salvation to the ends of the earth." It's not saying that all the nations shall become part of Israel, but it is saying that the servant of the Lord, who redeems Israel, will also bring salvation to the nations. Therefore, those who are not Jews are received into his kingdom, as well as those who are Jews. The implication being that you don't have to become a Jew to be saved. And Peter says, well, God has done this by giving them the Holy Spirit. I didn't pray that they should receive the Holy Spirit. I just came to start explaining to them what had happened concerning Jesus. But God gave them the Holy Spirit. As he poured out his Spirit on us at the beginning, so he poured it out on them. And they were speaking in Gentile languages the wonderful works of God. Witnessing this immediately reminded me of when the Holy Spirit came to us at Pentecost. Now, Peter explains the history. It wasn't his idea. It was something that God arranged. He sent an angel to Cornelius, giving him instructions to summon Peter, and he gave a vision to Peter showing that he was to go with the men that turned up. And the two things came together, so that immediately after receiving his vision, the three men sent from Cornelius were at the door asking for him. And Peter had not acted alone in this. There were six brethren that he took with him. They were witnesses that Peter's account of the events is true. The charge against Peter was specifically, you went into uncircumcised men and ate with them. But this is exactly what was addressed in the vision that Peter had received. Because when he saw the sheet let down from heaven, containing all sorts of birds and animals and creeping things, he heard the instructions, arise, Peter, kill and eat. And when he protested, not so, Lord, nothing common or unclean has at any time entered my mouth, the voice said, what God has cleansed, you must not call common. Jewish people considered Gentiles unclean because they ate unclean food. But God has declared they are no longer unclean because he has cleansed them. And indeed Peter was to eat with them. And the instruction to me was simple. Arise, Peter, kill and eat. So this food barrier that separated the Jews from the Gentiles within the church was no longer to be a barrier. He was to go with these people and receive food in their house. For that was the accusation. You went to uncircumcised men and ate with them. Peter doesn't deny that he accepted the hospitality of these people. But it wasn't his initiative to go. It was an instruction from the Spirit of God. Considering the other side, Cornelius had received the instruction, send men to Joppa and call for Simon, whose surname is Peter, who will tell you words by which you and all your household will be saved. Cornelius had set up a godly household with servants who believed in God, soldiers who believed in God working under him. Therefore, he gathered his close friends and household to hear what Peter had to say. Words by which you and your household will be saved. This word saved keeps recurring in the account of Acts, for we need to be saved. Peter says, save yourself from this perverse generation. Whoever believes in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ shall be saved, whether Jew or Gentile. The sign of salvation is the presence of the Holy Spirit, evidenced by the confession, Jesus is Lord, that Jesus is the Messiah, that Jesus died for the sins of the world and rose for our justification. Those who were challenging Peter had no answer to him. They became silent, and they glorified God, saying, then God has also granted to the Gentiles repentance to life. But as more and more Gentiles came into the fellowship of the church, some Jewish background believers would continue to be confronted by Gentiles in their fellowship.